hope, the love, the peace, the joy, the life, the one we are yearning.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hi, good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Glory Tabernacle Healing and Deliverance Prayer Line, together with the Consuming Fire Radio Ministry. This is the portion where we share the word, and before I call on Sister Cynthia, let me call on Sister Claire to open up in prayers.
Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for tonight. We welcome your Holy Spirit's presence and anointing on this prayer line. And Lord, we ask you to just anoint Bishop Mel as he brings forth. Oh, please anoint Sister Cynthia with your Holy Spirit's fire of anointing, Lord God, that as she brings forth the word, Lord God, let us hear from you through your vessel tonight, Lord God. And Lord, we pray that your name would be glorified and honored. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. May I call on Sister Cynthia?
Amen. Good evening, brethren. Good evening. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just want to just give God thanks again for another prayer night, another starting off another week.
Amen.
We are on our prayer line. We thank God for taking us through. Tonight, we are going to look at a subject, the way you think. The way you think. And we will use as our basis. We read from the book of Mark, chapter 11, verse 24, the key verses. And then the book of Luke, chapter 5, verses 1 through 10. Let me hold that. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So we're going to read these verses of scriptures. Before we do, let's have a word of prayer again. Father, in the name of Jesus, here we, your sons and daughters, have gathered together on this prayer line. Oh Lord, that you have guarded and protected, oh God, and Father God, that you have used, oh God, and continue to use to reach souls. Tonight, we want to just thank you and praise you for the honor that you have given to our prayer line members. And we want to just thank you for the victory we've had over the prayer line. And tonight, as we sit down again to examine your word, because you always come fresh, your word is living. And each time we read it, we get more and more different revelations to it. We want you to just thank you for this, oh God. So tonight we invite you, Holy Spirit, our teacher and counselor and guide, to take us through this lesson. And may we all be blessed at the end of it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Are you hearing me? Pastor Marina?
Amen, Sister Cynthia.
Yes, you're not responding. I don't know if I'm coming up.
I was on mute. Sorry.
Oh, okay. All right, so we're looking at the book of Mark, and our first scripture, we're going to read Mark 11, and we will read from verses 12, 13, 14, and 20, but our key verse is 24. Mark 11 and verse 12. Are you there?
We're here.
Okay. Mark 11, 12, and it reads, And on the morrow, when they were come from Bethany, he was hungry. Verse 13 of that chapter 12. In the book of Mark, and seeing a fig tree afar off, having leaves, he came, if happily he might find anything thereon. And when he came to it, he found nothing but leaves, for the time of figs was not yet. And verse 20. No, verse 14. And Jesus answered and said unto it, No, that is verse 14, no man eat fruit of thee hereafter forever. And his disciples heard it. And verse 20, and in the morning as they passed by, they saw the fig tree dried up from the roots. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And verse 24, before we go to 24, it says, verse 22, we have the part which says, Jesus said, have faith in God. And verse 24, therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire, when ye pray, believe that ye receive them, and ye shall have them. Amen. That was from the book of Mark, chapter 11, and verses 12, 13, 20, 22, and 24. And we go to our other scriptural basis. Turn over with me to the book of Luke, chapter 5. Luke chapter 5, and I read. And it came to pass that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two ships standing by the lake, but the fishermen were gone out of them and were washing their nets. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon's, and prayed him, asked him, that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out into the deep and let down your nets. For a drought. Launch out, that is verse 4, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a drought. And verse 5, and Simon answering said unto him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. Verse 6, and when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fishes, and their net brake. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And verse 8, and when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' feet, saying, depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. Hallelujah. So these are your scriptural basis for the way you think, the message of tonight. I once, a long time ago, or maybe you have also read this saying, or came across this saying that you are what you eat. And there was another statement, again, I came across, that was when I was going to school anyway, it says, you are what you think all day long. And I think this was an American writer, Waldo Emerson, I think, who said that you are what you think all day long. Now, the verses of scripture that we have just read is to enlighten the topic I have chosen, the way you think. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Now, in the first example I gave to you with the fig tree, where Jesus passed by and saw the fig tree wanting to eat of the figs, wanting figs, but when he drew close by, it happened that there was no figs on the tree. And Jesus cursed the tree right there and then. So we want to see why, because it was not the time of the fig tree to bring forth fruit, bring forth figs. And yet, Jesus decided to curse the tree. And when he had cursed the tree dried up right from the very roots. But of course, he did what he had to do. He cursed the tree, and the tree was cursed from the very roots. His disciples saw the tree still standing there when he did that. Well, they probably wondered. But then the next morning when they passed by, the tree was indeed dried up from the roots. And for those of us who live in the tropics and we know about fig trees just don't dry up instantly. In fact, they are the only things you will find in very, very desert places or hot weather where they will have sap, they will have water. And so if the tree is dying, it will take some days before it will, you know, die altogether. At least the leaves will begin to droop and the tree will begin to bend or sway. But you would not see dryness, dry leaves, as you have in this case here where Jesus cursed the tree. And immediately, Jesus had seen that the tree was already cursed and dried up. But his disciples did not see it until the next day. And I want to believe that Jesus went by, you know, he is all-knowing. He has all the... He's God in the flesh. He's all-knowing. And so when he cursed the tree, he knew it was done immediately. His disciples did not know that. I believe that Jesus passed by that tree, his going by was intentional. I believe he was about to teach his disciples another lesson on life, another lesson on a mind change. A lesson where they will learn how to have a mindset to adjust to any confrontation in any given situation, how they can develop a mindset. Jesus said that every impossible with a new way of thinking. The disciples, of course, were astonished that the tree had withered away so soon. Like I said, the fig tree does not wither away just like that. It has water in it, much water. But if you know anything about a fig tree, it should stand there for some days well before its branches begin to droop. But Scripture tells us it was dried up, even from its roots, way down into the ground. Jesus had confidence in the Word of God. And that's what he said to them, because as I said earlier on, he wanted to teach them a lesson on life and changing your mind. He says to them, have faith in God. Brethren, what can I say? What is the source of your faith? the source of our faith is the Word of God. So then, when we are confronted with impossible situations, what do? We use the Word of God. Our faith in the Word of God will bring forth the desired well. Our faith in the Word of God will bring forth the desired results. Why? Because the Bible let us know that the Word of God shall not return void, but will accomplish that for which it was sent forth. So if our faith is built on the Word of God and we're using the Word of God to get our desired results. But what I am trying to draw here to your attention is that the way you think. Jesus thought positively. When I say positively, he just had faith. It's not positive thinking anyway. Jesus just had faith that when he commanded this fig tree, even right there and then, that he would get the desired results. And like I said, Jesus passed that way intentionally so that his disciples have a lesson on life. Okay. That a new mindset is needed always for every situation. And I will show you in the second example I have chosen from the book of Mark, on the book of Luke, chapter 5, and we read it. In the book of Luke, chapter 5, and we read from verses 1 to 10, Jesus at Lake Gennesaret in a boat teaching the people as he always does. His disciples, then they were fishermen at the time, were nearby and washing their nets. For they had thrown in, they had given up. They had gone out to sea to fish, and they got nothing. And they just, like, they threw the towel, washing their nets and gingerly not caring. That was the end of business for the day. They didn't have a catch. Even as far as they had gone out into the deep waters where you would normally find fish, they had labored all night and found nothing. And of course, they were disappointed. They were frustrated over the situation. But then comes along Jesus and saying to Simon, Peter, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for a draught. And of course, Simon hesitated with an explanation of his previous experience. He told Jesus that they were out all night and they caught nothing. But nevertheless, he decided to do as he was commanded by Jesus. Now, we are still keeping in view our topic tonight, the way we think. As Peter and the others went back to launch their net, Jesus commanded them. He said, go back and launch your net. And you know, as they were going back into the seas again, what do you think they were thinking? What do you think was going on in their minds? Now they have been there. There were no fishes there, as they said. And now Jesus is asking them to go back. So now as you are going back, or as they went back, before they got into the waters, you know, they had to reorient their thinking and have a change of mind. So as they went towards the deep to launch, they, in their mind's eye, saw shoals of fish. even before their nets were let down. Have faith in God, Jesus had told his disciples at the fig tree. And now here Peter and the other fishermen looked, took Jesus upon his words in an act of obedience. And in that act of obedience, what was the result? A great multitude of fishes, and what happened? Their net break. Brethren, what are we to learn here? We are to learn here that every impossible situation becomes possible with God. And most importantly in this lesson, every failure should be revisited with the Word of God. Have faith in God. When we go for an interview and we failed and we have got to go back again, what do? We have faith. We begin to see what was impossible possible. Anything. Because here were the disciples and these fishermen, they were experienced people. They knew about fishing. That is their territory, and that's their profession or their vocation. And yet, when they fished and had gotten nothing, and when they went back, now when you are going back, if you were in their situation, you're not going back and thinking, okay, well, no, there's no fish there. No, you begin to see fishes there. You begin to see the catch that you wanted there. And that takes a change of mind, reorienting your mind. And so because they had a change of mind, they reoriented their mindset, and as they went and they let down their nets, what did they have? Multitude of fish. So we need to remember that our faith is built upon the Word of God. Our faith rests upon the Word of God. And the Word must perform wherever it is sent. In Romans 12:2, we are told, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Where the world will say, no, oh, give up on that, don't bother with that sort of thing, what do you think? No, you need to revisit every situation that has troubled you. Revisit it with the Word. And that is what Jesus was teaching his disciples at the time when, or the fishermen when he met them, to go back and revisit that scene. No fishes there, you go back with a new mindset, seeing that there are fishes there. There must be fishes there. Revisit the situation again with the Word of God. And remember, the Word of God must perform every time it is used. So here was Jesus. So here is Jesus teaching these two very, very important lessons, life lessons. The fig tree, he wanted his disciples to know that they can change their mind, and as they change their mind, they change situations around. He wanted them to see that nothing is impossible with the Word of God. Remember that God works upon our impossibilities. What is not possible for us is possible with God. And I cannot remember, James said, I think it is James who said, we have not because we ask not. That is, we can look at it again. It's our subject tonight. We have asked once and we leave it there. We need to revisit the situation again, seeing it with the Word of God. Before I close, I want you to remember God is faithful to perform in your lives all His promises. He has given us promises. We are heirs of His kingdom, inheritors through Jesus Christ. So therefore, He has to be faithful. God is faithful to His promises that He has given to His children. And so we have to build upon His confidence, not our self-confidence. In the case of the fishermen, because they were experienced fishermen, they have done this trade over the years. And so they were confident that if when they went and there was no fish there, if they say there is no fish, then there is no fish. But Jesus here told them that they can have a new mindset and turn it around and find fish. So too, I'm stressing that no matter what our situation is, we can always revisit it with the Word of God, which must be performed and not written void. It must perform. Because it's only the Word of God can deliver. So then, what is our take home from this lesson? From this lesson, where I gave to you from the book of Mark 11, 12, 13, 20, 22, and 24, and the book of Luke 5, from verses 1 through 10, you may see. We learn this. Have faith in God. Do not or don't operate on your past experiences, nor your ability, whether it was good or bad. Do not operate. Do not think or plan in your past because you are this or you are that, this qualification, this experience. If you're a child of God, you cannot. Your experience is only God's experience. Faith in God. Thirdly, you would build confidence in the Word to increase your faith. As you believe the Word and your confidence is built up, your faith grows, your faith increases. And fourth, you must be willing to change your mindset on a situation, even instantly, and change your mindset with the Word of God. Apply a new promise of God's word to the situation. That's what Jesus did to the disciples when he asked them to go back right away. And they had a new mindset as they went back. And because of this new mindset, they did find a multitude of fish. Fifth, you must believe in what you are doing or speaking, doing or saying. If you believe in what the Word of God says on the situation, you must believe it as you speak it. And the sixth point is that you must expect results. The unexpected, as was in the case with the fishermen, they were going now with a new mindset to catch, to have a big catch, and indeed they have. You must expect results and expect the unexpected. And lastly, always give God the thanks. Give God the thanks. So, brethren, I hope that I have helped you, because when we look at these books, we always see faith. And we see one most people talk about faith in just this one way. But here, Jesus was showing us that with our faith and with the word of God, we can alter a situation around, as was shown in these scriptures here. And it's nothing to do with having a positive mindset. No, not thinking positively. It's just revisiting the situation with the word of God and having confidence in God's word, not yourself. Visiting the situation with the word of God, having confidence in the word as you verbalize it, and expecting results. You must expect results when you go in that direction. So this is really what we have tonight, the way you think. Just the way you think. And I've given you the scriptures. Hallelujah, hallelujah. So this is the message for tonight, the way you think. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We have to reorient our way of thinking on many things. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I want to just thank you, oh Lord, thank you for this subject. When I was reading these chapters, Lord, this is what Holy Spirit that you dropped into my spirit. And I just thank you for using me to be able to show more depth into those scriptures. We have read it many, many times, but we have never seen it in this, at least I have never seen it in this angle. You have given it to me tonight, and I have given to your sons and daughters. So, Father God, we want to just thank you again. We want to thank you because we know that you are the one who leads us, the one who guides us, the one who shields us. You're the one who is upgrading us every time, oh God. We thank you, oh God, that, Lord, today where there's such a scarcity, oh God, of your word, oh God, the Holy Scriptures, oh God, and that, Lord, it is like right now that the church, oh Lord, is battling and struggling for its life, for its very survival, oh God, with the attacks and onslaught of other religions and other books, oh God. But, Lord, we will prevail because you and your word, you are one, O God. And the word will prevail and will triumph, O God. And so we pray and ask, O God, to help us, O God, to teach it as it is. Lord, that we may not be found wanting on that great day, O God, that we deny the truth to the people, Lord. We pray that this would not be so on our prayer line, O Lord, that whenever we teach, O Lord, or we come to discuss, Lord, it is just your word, O God, and nothing but your word which is the truth. So tonight we want to just thank you again. Holy Spirit, your presence is here with us. We are more than two gathered in your name. And I know that the prayer requests coming in, as you have done before, and you continue to do, you incline your ear onto our prayers, and you answer, and you give us victory, sometimes not always, but we know that your time is the best time. It is you and you alone, because you are alone. You are omniscient, omnipotent, and everywhere. Omniscience, omnipotent, and what is this now? So, Father God, you're all. There's nothing that you cannot do, oh God. So tonight we want to just thank you once more. Thank you, oh God, for your goodness, your love and kindness, for your provision in every way and in every life, oh God. We give you thanks again for the word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister Cynthia, for that word. Once again, the title of the sharing tonight is The Way You Think, Mark 11, verses 24, 12, 13, 14, 20, and 22. Also, Luke 5, verses 1 to 10. Hallelujah. What a beautiful word tonight. So, thank you once again, Sister Cynthia, and we are now in the portion of taking your prayer requests. Once again, this is Glory Tabernacle Healing and Deliverance Prayer Line, together with the Consuming Fire Radio Ministry. We are broadcasted globally tonight. And before we go to our prayer requests and praise reports, we would like to let everyone know that starting today, we started fasting and prayer. Hallelujah. Maybe a week or two with all this, what's going on around us, ISIS threat, and also a lot of Christian children, adults are having beheaded because of the ISIS. They occupied a place now is under them, and we are letting everybody know to pray and fast. We don't know how long this will be going on, and it's disturbing that they were able to get one place, and our only help is from the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So, also I have some prayer requests from Steve, our constantly friend from that sends this prayer request most of the time in the email, and this time he wants us to pray for Karen M. to be healed of all infirmity, weakness, and pain in her body, for the depression to lift off and stay off of her, for dunamis power, light, and strength to come in and drive the enemy out, and for her to have financial breakthrough, for her bills to be paid, for repairs to be done. Amen. Thank you and bless you. Hallelujah. So we will lift those up, and whatever prayer requests we get tonight, we will lift them up. And so do you have any prayer requests, praise reports that lift up? Hallelujah. Who has a prayer request tonight?
Hi, Sister Claire. Good night. This is Sister Samantha. I'm asking if you can please pray for me. I'm not well. My hands, my feet, my body is paining me. And my two hands is swelling and getting red.
What is that, Sister Samantha? You're what?
I'm not well. I have bad aches. My body aches me. My hands swelling, getting red, it's peeling in. If you can please pray for me. Thank you, Sister Claire.
Okay. Thank you, Sister Samantha. Go ahead.
Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for the word that you gave us through Sister Cynthia. Lord, we pray that it bless your people tonight. And Lord, that, Lord, they learned your word and got to know you in a deeper way through your word, Lord, that you spoke to them through your word tonight, Lord. And Lord, tonight we lift up Sister Samantha, Lord God. We pray that you would take away her pain in her body and the swelling and the redness, Lord God. And we pray for complete healing and restoration for her, Lord. And Lord, we lift up her family to you, that you would bring salvation to every member of her family. her son, her daughter, her brother, her mother, Lord God, that they may come to know you, Lord Jesus, as their Lord and Savior, Lord God. Lord, touch their hearts, Lord God. Open their hearts and their minds to receive you as their Lord, Lord God. And Lord, tonight we also lift up Karen, Lord God, to be healed from her sickness, to be released from the oppression that's in her life, Lord God. And Lord, provide for her needs. Give her a financial breakthrough that, Lord, she would have provision to pay her bills and repairs, Lord God. And Lord, we thank you for tonight, Lord God. We thank you for everyone listening to this broadcast. We pray, Lord God, for the silent listeners, that, Lord, you've blessed them tonight, that they've heard the word, Lord God, and drew closer to you, Lord. And Lord, as we lift up the people on this prayer line, as we intercede for them, Lord, we lift up every prayer intercessor, that as they lift up the needs of your people, Lord, that, Lord, you would hear their requests as well, Lord God. Lord, we thank you for every prayer request tonight, Lord, and we thank you for the answer that's coming, Lord. And, Lord, let your name be glorified. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Thank you, Sister Claire.
You're welcome. Thanks, Sister Samantha.
You're welcome.
Amen. Anybody else on the prayer line with a prayer request?
Yes, I have a prayer request.
Go ahead, Sister Sister Cynthia.
Yes, I would like prayers for a young woman, a teenager, who I suspect is having what they call bulimia, where she vomits after eating her food. She just keeps vomiting. So they want to pray, I believe it's a spirit, and they want to just let her up to this unwholesome behavior. But God will intervene. Amen. God will intervene.
Amen.
Jesus left her up.
Yeah. May I call on Sister Lila?
Oh, Pastor Marina, good evening.
Good evening. Can you please lift up this young girl, lady that Sister Cynthia has mentioned, that she's throwing up and it's probably ritual battle that
Bulimia. What is this young woman today? They want to keep nice, they want to be slim. Or they want to keep the weight down, and then they try to provoke vomiting so that they would not have any food in their stomach, cause them to get or generate energy or whatever. But it's, you know, intentional provoking the vomiting because of the weight, that they want to be slim. This young woman in question, she's 19 years old. She's called Abby.
Amen. Did you hear that, Sister Lai?
Yes. Oh, thank you, Sister Cynthia.
Okay.
Okay, thank you. Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed. Heal me, and I will be saved. Heal me, O Lord, and I will be healed, for you are the one I praise, for you are the one we praise. Thank you, dear God, our loving Father, for this wonderful night. Again, you put us all together in this prayer line. We thank you for the word that you have given us to Sister Cynthia. And tonight, Lord, we would like to ask a favor from you to give your healing power to this young girl who is suffering from, very intense stomach trouble because she's taking up some drinks to make her slim. Oh God, whatever pain or damage that was caused by these drinks that she's taking. Lord, please stop her vomiting or stop the pain that she's having right now, oh God. You're the only one who can heal her. We cried unto you to touch this girl, oh God, and give her the full recovery from this pain from her stomach, oh God. And may she revive herself again, revive her good feeling, oh God. Please surround her with your love and your mercy, and please provide her in all her needs. And we pray for her salvation and for her family, oh God, to surround her with more love and compassion at this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Sister Lai.
God bless everybody.
God bless you. Sister Marina, you have any prayer requests?
I don't have any.
Oh, praise the Lord. Can we lift up those that are under attack? Being a Christian and also because of what's going on around us, and that we are, those who are innocent are getting involved, and they have all this fear about what's going on. Okay, Sister Marina.
And wait, what is this about the one that's Christians being beheaded?
Yes, yes. And okay. Fear is going around, especially in that place, because most of them that are being beheaded are Christians.
Yeah. But you know, I heard a testimony from one of the brothers of the one that is beheaded.
Yeah.
And the brother of one of those beheaded said that, I thank God that my brother sacrifice for the Lord.
Praise God.
So he was very thankful that his brother is now with the Lord and in his faith. And one of the mother of one of those beheaded said, I forgive them and I pray for them that they will know the Lord. So they are standing strong in their faith.
Yes. Stand firm.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord, we praise you. We praise you, O Lord. We worship you. Help us to worship you, O Lord. Help us, O Holy Spirit, to worship you. Worship God above all things. Hallelujah. That we will not have any idols in our lives, O Lord God, but to you we will worship you and you alone, O Lord. We will not worship, O Lord God, the news. We will not worship, O Lord God, the material things around us. We will not worship, O Lord, the report, O Lord God. Whose report would you believe? We will believe the report of the Lord. O Lord God, we lift up to you the situation, O Lord God. And that ISIS, O Lord. Oh, Lord God, we praise you for your people standing firm in your faith, oh, Lord God. Oh, Lord God, we lift them up unto you for this family that is left, oh, Lord God. The family, oh, Lord God, that they're mourning, oh, Lord God, give them peace and give them love, oh, Lord. Oh, Lord, we pray, oh, Lord God, be glorified through this, oh, Lord. There's so many situations in the Bible, oh, Lord God, that man made it for bad, but God made it for good. It is when Christians are persecuted. It is when Christians are being put down that Christians become strong. It is there, O Lord God, when your name is glorified, O Lord God. When Nero, O Lord God, ordered for the Christians
healed. That is when your word spread. That is when your glory, O Lord God, came through, O Lord God. Let your glory be known. Let your glory, O Lord God, be there in the place, O Lord God. O Lord God, O Lord God, that they are intimidating us, O Lord God. O Lord God, let that be fear in our hearts, in the hearts of your children who believe in you. That you will be strong in us. We pray, O Lord God, that we will stand firm in our faith. O Lord God, that you will be glorified through this, O Lord. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. We praise you, O Lord God. We pray for that place, O Lord God, that we occupied. O Lord God, as it is said, O Lord God, Peter is a professional fisherman, O Lord God, but he did not catch anything. But when you told him to cast their net in the other side, in the right side, there was, O Lord, you were not a fisherman, you are a carpenter, but you are God. O Lord God, teach them, O Lord God, to fish, to cast their net on the right side, O Lord God. Teach us, O Lord, and we will obey. Because you said so, we will obey to cast our nets in the right side. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Help us, O Lord God, to be firm in our faith, O Lord. Help us, O Holy Spirit. Help us, O Lord God. O Lord God, that we will be strong even if we are being, a fear is being implanted. The fear is not given unto us, O Lord God. The fear is not from you. We were not given the spirit of fear, but spirit of love and a sound mind and power, O Lord. Thank you, Lord God, for that. Thank you, Lord God, for the spirit of power, for the spirit of love, for the spirit of sound mind, O Lord God. We praise you and we thank you, Lord God. We lift up to you this Isis, O Lord. Touch them, O Lord God. Touch them, O Lord God, in any way. You speak, O Lord God, to Lazarus to come forth, and he come forth. You told Moses, O Lord God, to speak to the rock. You speak to the sea, O Lord God, to the storm and the still. Speak, O Lord God, to the ice. We pray, O Lord God, for their salvation, O Lord God, that they will know you, that they will praise you, O Lord. They will come, O Lord God, unto you, O Lord. O Lord God, Paul was persecuting your children, your church, O Lord God. But you touch him, O Lord God. We pray, O Lord God, that you will touch them. That this spirit, O Lord God, of Goliath, the spirit of intimidation that is being posed upon us by the press, by the news, by the internet, O Lord God, that they are trying to put fear in our hearts. O Lord God, the spirit of fear is not from you. We have you in our hearts, O Lord. You have given us the spirit of power, the spirit of love, and the spirit of a sound mind. O Lord God, that we may have that. We praise and we thank you, Lord God, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you.
God. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister Marina. Who else is on the prayer line with a prayer request?
My name is Reed. I have a prayer request, if it's okay. Thank you. It's okay, yeah.
Hallelujah.
Okay,
Sister Rita.
Thank you. My brother's smoking again. He was dying Christmas, and he won't stop smoking, and his lungs are very big. Pray for him. Also, place for him to stay. And also, I was on medication for antidepressants. I want to know if I should get off him or not. I'm off them about 3 weeks now. I don't know if it's God's will for me to get off the antidepressants. I need guidance, you know? Thank you.
Amen. Go ahead, Sister Claire.
Heavenly Father, we want to lift up all those who are sick tonight, Lord God, for Sister Samantha, Sister Rita, and everyone who needs your healing tonight, Lord. Lord, we lift up Sister Rita, that, Lord, you would give her guidance, Lord God. Lord, help her, Lord God, to trust in you concerning her medication. But, Lord, let her be compliant with what the doctor tells her, Lord God, because you are using the doctors, even these physicians, to help
bring about healing to our bodies, Lord God. Lord, we also lift up everyone she knows, her brother John, her friend who is in the hospital, Lord God, that, Lord, you would bring complete healing and restoration to each one of them, and Sister Rita as well, Lord God. Lord, concerning her antidepressant medication, Lord God, Lord, give her wisdom and guidance. Let her seek help from a physician, Lord God, if she needs help in this area, Lord God. Lord, you will be the one to bring complete healing and restoration, Lord. Let her not be depressed or whatever is going on in her mind, Lord God, that, Lord, you would bring peace that surpasses understanding, that, Lord, whatever it is that is causing her to be depressed, Lord God, Lord, we pray and we lift it up to you, Lord God, that you would be the one, Lord, to give her peace in her mind, Lord God, and anything that's causing her to worry or think too much about certain things, Lord God, we pray, Lord God, that you would bring calmness, Lord God, peace, Lord God, into that area in her mind, Lord, that, Lord, she would trust and believe in you, Lord, in all things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you very much. I'm very grateful. Thank you.
Thank you, Sister Rita. May I call on Brother Tom? Hi,
yes,
Brother Tom. Good evening.
Hi, Sister Maureen. How are you?
Praise the Lord. We're good. And can you please lift up all our spiritual leaders and also leaders of our nation?
Yes.
And all these happenings that's going on around us. Okay, Brother Tom?
Sure. Father, we thank you tonight. We worship you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We glorify you. Thank you, Jesus. Heavenly Father, we pray for the leaders. We pray for Evangelist Mike and Minister Robin. We pray for Pastor Mel. We pray for leaders of the church and the body of Christ here in America. We pray you strengthen them, revive them, fill them with fresh fire, fresh anointing tonight. Strengthen them, Lord God. Touch them from the top of their heads to the bottom, soles of their feet. Let your fire burn their hearts. Fill them with overflowing joy and strength. Fill them with the fire of your Holy Spirit, that you refresh them and revive them and strengthen them in these evil times that we live, Father, to keep them strong and to keep them pure and holy and righteous to a lost and hurting, dying world, Father. Oh, God, we also pray, Lord God, for President Obama. Help him, Lord, to be a strong leader. Lord, help him to be a good leader in this, for our nation, for America, and the leader of the world, Father. America used to be a leading country, Lord. Oh, God, help him to make the right decisions for America, Lord. Help him to support Israel again, Lord Jesus.
Yes.
Because before we used to support Israel, Lord. Now he's supporting the enemies of Israel. Lord God, forgive him, Lord. He doesn't know what he's saying or doing. We pray you give this man wisdom and knowledge, Lord. Help him, Lord. Save him and his family. Save his presidential staff. He has the Muslim Brotherhood on his staff, dear God. He's giving a favor to the Muslims, Lord God, and not any favor to Israel. Lord Jesus, we also pray for Benjamin Netanyahu, Father, as he addresses Congress, dear God, next month, Father. We pray that President Obama, we pray that the Western European countries would wake up. Lord, we're in a difficult time where Iran wants to wipe out Israel. They want to wipe out America. Lord Jesus, just like in the time of the book of Esther, where the enemies of Israel wanted to destroy Israel completely, we're in that time of history now where the enemies of Israel want to destroy, annihilate all the Jews in Israel. And Father God, we just pray that you'd wake up this country, wake up the leaders in this nation, wake up President Obama, wake up the Western European countries that are not taking the Prime Minister of Israel serious about Iran, that Iran is a major threat to the world, not just for America and Israel, but for other nations, and that they will not make their nuclear weapon, Father. Oh God, we pray that he would be strong. that he would not try to pacify the enemies of America or Israel. Help him, Lord Jesus, not to make friends with our enemies, but to be a good leader, a strong leader, Father. So we pray for his salvation, Lord. Save him and his family, Lord God. Open his eyes, open his heart, Father.
Yes,
oh,
Lord.
Jesus, have mercy, Lord. Have mercy, Father. We are living in very perilous and evil times right now. And, oh, God, we pray you protect our nation, Lord, with the upcoming threats that are going to come happen in this coming April. Something terrible will be happening. The State Department knows about it. Also, it was prophesied from a man of God who is a Jewish believer. He said that the Lord spoke to his heart that they're going to do some kind of attack against our nation in April. But, Lord, we're not to be afraid, because greater is he that is in us than he that is in this world. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. We know that you will protect us, Father. You will watch over us, dear God. And we just pray that, Lord, our borders would be sealed, Father. We just pray that you give the FBI and the CIA wisdom and knowledge, Father. Pray for their salvation. Pray that you give them wisdom, Lord God. And, Lord, just keep the terrorism out of our nation, Father God. Protect our borders. Protect this nation, Father.
Yes,
from all terroristic activities, Father God. We pray, Lord Jesus, that our government, the FBI and the CIA, would give them wisdom, Lord. You would give them supernatural discernment and wisdom and knowledge to stop these terrorist groups that are in our country, Lord God. That, Lord, they would stop them, Lord God. The ones in Minnesota, the Al-Qaeda that's in this nation, and all these other terrorist groups that are in this country, Father, that they would stop them, Father God, from planning out their evil attacks, Father God. Oh, God, have mercy, Lord, even in these terrorist groups they have in Minnesota, Lord. They're training them in Minnesota, and they're flying out to go to Turkey, to go to Syria, to fight with ISIS, Lord. Oh, God, have mercy, Lord.
Amen.
Have mercy, Father. Lord, we pray you bring confusion in the enemy camp in Syria and Iraq, also in Nigeria, Lord. Bring confusion in the enemy camp with this Boko Haram. Oh, God, we pray that they'll be extinguished, Lord, that you'd wipe them out, dear God. You'd send judgment upon them, Lord. Lord, I do agree that you for their salvation, Lord, but if they don't want to be saved, we pray that you would just send your judgment upon them. You deal with them the way you want to deal with these terrorists, Father. Have your way upon them, Lord God. Oh, God, because your word says a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. I do want to see them to be saved, Lord. I want to see them come to know you as their Lord and Savior. We definitely pray for their salvation first and utmost, Lord, that you would save them, you'd forgive them, for they don't know what they're saying or doing, because they're blinded by the hand of Satan. Their eyes are blinded by Satan. Open their eyes, open their hearts, Father. We pray for their salvation.
Hallelujah.
Oh, God, we thank you, Lord. Lord, do something miraculous, Father. We thank you, Lord, that despite all that evil and all the killing of believers and all these people in Syria and Iraq, we thank you for the 7,000 the Yazidi people have come to know you as their Lord and Savior. Thank you for the other multitudes of Muslims that have come to know you as their Savior at these refugee camps in Iraq, Father. We thank you, Lord, for many of them coming to know you as their Lord and Savior, Father. We thank you, Lord. Send a great revival in that area, Lord. Despite all the killing, despite all those that have died, we pray for those who are alive that you bring salvation to them, Lord. Do miracles.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, that all things work together for good for them that love the Lord and are called according to your will and purpose. Thank you for turning what the devil has meant for evil and harm. You turn around for your glory and honor, Father. Thank you, Jesus. We love you and bless you. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Brother Tom.
Thank you
very much. Hallelujah. God bless you. Yes. May I call on Sister Cynthia?
Yes, Master.
Hallelujah. Can you please lift up also all our intercessors and all those who need to meet their needs, those still looking for a job, apartments, and those undergoing financial difficulty right now, and after that, Sister Cynthia, you can close, okay?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. He is worthy, Lord. Thou art worthy, thou art worthy, thou art worthy. You are worthy, mighty Jehovah, you are worthy. All
Lord and our God, tonight again, O God, we just thank you, O God, for your graciousness, for your gracious presence this meeting, O God. We give you thanks, O God, for the honor that you give, O God, to our prayer line, O God. We thank you, O God, because each time we come, O God, and we intercede, O God, there you are as we call. Your word says, call and you will answer. And as we call, O God, indeed, you have answered and continue to answer, O God. Oh, Father God, your church is troubled, O God. But Father God, for those of us who have recruited, O God, to be in the army of the Lord, O God, as you have called us, O God, you have already equipped us, O God. And so tonight we want to just thank you, Lord. Tonight you spoke unto us, O God, in your word, O God, that if we launch out, O God, that we have a new mindset, a new way of thinking, O God, let this mind which is in Christ Jesus be in us. Christ had the mind of God, in that whatever he saw, whatever wanted to do, he was able to do it because of who he is. Because his eyes was always upon his Father. He himself confessed, I do nothing of myself, but only what my Father allows me to do. Father God, we come. We can do nothing without your grace, O God. It is grace that propels us every day to meet another day. Lord, without your grace that brings forth the anointing, O God, we are nowhere. We can do nothing, O God. Lord, you did not call us to failure. You did not call us to have a mind, but, O rather, a sound mind, O God. And so tonight, even as the word came, that the way we think, the way you think, having a sound mind is based upon your word, our trust in the word, our confidence in you, O God. Father God, for all of us who come on this prayer line, O God, help us to even just put aside for a moment, O Lord, our need, O God. But think about you, O God, the sacrifice that you made on behalf of mankind, O God, that your kingdom will come, your kingdom will be established, your kingdom will come, O God. O Father God, we need your grace, O God. We need, O God, mercy where we slip and we fall short, O God. Or we are calling upon you. You are our God who we call upon, the living God, the only one and true God. All other gods, they are false gods. They are no God, O God. And so you alone, O holy God of Israel, the God of Israel, the God of Abraham and Moses and Isaac and Jacob, you are this God whom we call upon. You are this God whom we serve. You are this God in trust. And you are this God who have said to us that we should not fear. Your word tells us, fear not, I will help thee. Fear not, thou worm Jacob, and ye men of Israel, I will help thee, saith the Lord, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. Father God, we pray, O God, for the Christians on this land and the Christians everywhere where the church is planted and there is a threat, O God. Yes, indeed, sacrifices have to be made. Fortunately, lives, innocent lives have to be taken. But, O God, you have the big picture. You know it all. But one thing we do know, as you have assured us, to fear not. We will be victorious. We will triumph. It doesn't matter what it looks like. You are never late. They may march in but they will not succeed, O God, because that's what you said, that in the end, O God, Israel will be spared, O God. Yes, there will be many things happening. So help us, O God. It is by our faith, by our word, O God, those of us whom we have called, that will help, O God, to propel the victory, propel the land forward for victory. Lord, and we pray for this nation. Lord, bless, O God. There's so much that is wrong internally, O God. And if our inside is not right, how can our outside be? Oh, God, you know all that is happening on this land, oh, God. Injustices, oh, God, neglect and improper decisions, wrong decisions, oh, God. Oh, Father God, you know it all and you saw it all. But I know, God, that you are never late coming. One thing it shows that when you come, oh, God, you are great. You are mighty. Oh, Lord, you put them, you silence our enemies indeed. And so, Father God, help us, those who are yours, oh, God, to keep on to be watchful and prayerful, oh, God. Never given an instant to the enemy, O God, to come into our lives. For we are on duty right now, O God. The church must be on duty. The church must rise. The church, O Father God, the church cannot allow division. The church cannot allow falsehood, O God. So, Father God, do your work, O God. All that needs to be wiped away, O God, let it be wiped away. That which needs to stand, let it stand, and what should not stand, let it fall, O God. But we know in the end, the church will triumph. The church will triumph. Help us, O God, that we also will triumph in our own lives, O God. We will know now the need to go out, the necessity, O God, the urgency to go out, O God. You heard what the brother have just said, planning in April. But, oh God, you are God. They can do what they want to do. It will only happen when you allow it. And when there's always purpose in whatever you do and whatever you plan, all we know that the victory is yours, has been yours, and will always be yours, no matter what the sacrifices may be. But we know that the victory, we have confidence in you because of your word. It's true. Your word cannot return void. You have said, and is going to fall. So, Father God, I want to just thank you again tonight, O God, that you will just, O Lord, visit your people, take away the fear, O God. Fear and faith cannot operate together, O God. But, Father God, upgrade us in our faith. Let us read the word and assimilate the word and eat up the word and trust the word and use the word even as your word came tonight. The way you think, oh God, we would revisit every situation that seemed to have been defeated, where there was defeat, where there was confusion, where there was failure. We would revisit it again with the word. Jesus said to the fishermen, seasoned fishermen, men who know their trade, they said there is no fish, there is no fish. But Jesus said, revisit the situation. And so for every situation, oh God, in the life of your people, oh God, in the life of the church, oh Father God, help us to get up and stand and revisit again. Revisit again. And surely the victory is ours. Tonight we want to just thank you again for who you are. We give you all the praise, all the glory. You have kept and preserved us and our families. We thank you for that. Your watchful eyes are upon us. You will continue to provide no matter what. You will continue to provide. We trust you, Lord. Our confidence is not in self nor in man. Our confidence is in you, Lord, in your word. So we want to just say thank you again, Father God. Thank you for your keeping power upon our leaders, O God, for intercessors, O God. Thank you for your keeping power, O God, upon your children, even those who have received, O God. Turn their lives around, O God, and bring them that they too will be part of the army in these last days, O God. You're willing that none should perish, but yet they have to come.
Oh, Lord, give them the mindset, oh God, to come in, to believe and to trust in your word. So we want to just thank you again. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Son. Thank you, Holy Spirit, all three in one. We give you the thanks. The praise is always yours, and the glory you will share with no other. We give you the glory, for you deserve it. You are wonderful. You are awesome, oh God. Awesome in your ways, awesome in the works of your hands, because you are God. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We will worship and adore you tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen. Hallelujah. On behalf of Glory Tabernacle Prayer Line and the Consuming Fire Radio Ministry, we bid you good night until tomorrow, and God bless you. As we go out, let's worship the Lord.